If you're new to the channel, please be sure to like, share, and of course subscribe and leave a comment down below. And also check out our partners, Nerds in the Hood, down in the description. And I hope to see you later on. Peace out. What's up, you guys, and welcome to another Alternative Factuals video. And if you're new to the channel, remember to check the links down in the description. We have four podcasts, well, have our podcast information, as well as our other social media accounts and all that stuff, so that way you guys can check out what we have going on Facebook, Twitter, and as well as Instagram. But without further ado, let's kind of jump into today's video. So obviously a lot of you know that I'm a very big fan of Black Lightning as a whole, as his character, but I was even more excited when they decided to make a series, and the first season was an extreme success. Now today we actually have some information regarding season 2, the first 3 episodes that are going to be released for season 2, October 9th, for the Black Lightning television show. And the name of the episodes, well, episodes 1, 2, and 3 will be called The Book of Consequences, The Rise of the Green Light Babies, Chapter 1. Now obviously I can't give you any more information than that, because that's the only information that we're kind of given access to regarding season 2 of Black Lightning. However, due to the title, we obviously can make some nice little predictions and infer some information regarding at least the first 3 episodes, but also overall season 2, what we can expect going forward. Now, once again, the title is called The Book of Consequences, The Rise of the Green Light Babies. Now, let's kind of break down the title a little bit, and then we can kind of piece together some information about season 2 as a whole and what we're going to be seeing. So I'm going to start off with just the, obviously, the Book of Consequences. Now, obviously, season 2 is going to be a consequence of the things that have taken place for season 1. So basically, everything that's led up to this point of Jefferson Pierce, aka Black Lightning, coming out of retirement, him going against Tobias, him, well, not him specifically, but Tobias himself actually creating Khalil, making him Painkiller. Also, how Tobias lost his sister. His sister died because of a stray bullet that was meant technically for him, but she ended up receiving it and thus died. A lot of consequences on both people's end, where Black Lightning, obviously his children have powers. One of his daughters is his sidekick officially. Gambi and his past coming out of light. And basically a lot of stuff that we've kind of figured out in season 1 is going to be a major factor for season 2. And that's, like I said, I think that's relatively obvious for the most part. That's kind of a given. But the title kind of confirms, at least for the first 3 episodes, we're going to see a lot of that coming back and kind of seeing how the characters are going to react to a lot of the situations that they've kind of brought on themselves in the first season. Now, the rise of the green light babies. Now, a lot of you may have seen the Static Shock show and remembered when they referred to Bang Babies. Now, Bang Babies were the people who were initially exposed to the radiation, the same radiation that Static Shock was exposed to, which gave him his electromagnetic abilities. Thus, he was able to manipulate electromagnetic phenomena and all that stuff, electricity, and all that good stuff. Now, I think, like I said, I'm not sure. I don't think in this season they'll introduce not Black Lightning, but Static Shock. However, I think the title in itself is kind of a teaser for a future that is very much possible. And for those of you who may or may not know, even in the Justice League comics, Static Shock was a mentee to Black Lightning due to the fact that their powers were extremely similar. And obviously, ethnically, racially wise, they were both Black, African American, but they lived in 2 different states in the United States in the DC universe. Cool and dandy. But that's just me referring to the fact that they're saying, like, you know, green light babies, which I think was just a little reference to Bang Babies, like I said, which took place, well, it's a term that's used in the Static Shock comics or TV show, if you've seen it back in like 2004, I believe. But yes, now to kind of go into a little bit, not earlier into the title, but the rise of the green light. Now I'm going to forget the babies part because I already just did that clearly, but the rise of the green light. Now, what I believe, and I'm pretty sure a lot of us can agree, is that green light is obviously what gave people like Black Lightning and his daughters, who inherited genetically his abilities or the green light abilities and thus developed their powers. Obviously, there has to be more people out there with powers who are maybe as old as Black Lightning himself, but also there are going to be more people that we've seen in those little experimental tubes and chambers that have been exposed to green light as a whole and will probably develop powers and some way, shape, or form be released into Freeland. And Black Lightning is probably going to encounter a few of them to kind of combat their abilities the best he possibly can. Now, what makes this interesting is also because, remember, Tobias, I believe, and I think it was actually relatively confirmed, because you see him looking in the suitcase and you see the green light of the actual substance in the case is reflecting off of him, and obviously green light being a substance that's green and the light of it being green. Tobias is actually going to use green light to create his own metahumans, thus kind of also making the title Rise of the Green Light Babies. So not only are we going to see people who were previously exposed to green light back in like the 60s and 70s when Black Lightning was a child himself or something like that, but also Tobias Whale is going to create people who has powers and use it to his advantage and kind of manipulate them the same way that he did for Khalil and made him kind of into this cybernetic metahuman. And what I mean cybernetic metahuman is that spinal implant that actually allows him to walk, but also gave him the ability to kind of excrete this toxin that causes people to numb their five senses and stuff like that. But this is really not about him specifically. Now with Tobias having access to green light, I kind of made a video of like the top five villains that you would see coming in season two, which I will link in the description down below. But also it really would give us access to different villains as well as different sets of powers that Black Lightning will have to consider, as well as different powers and how they'll affect the community. Now, one villain that I am particularly interested in that I would love to see is, like I said in the previous video having to do with the top five villains, is Ishmael. Now, Ishmael was a shapeshifter who literally can take shape of anybody, and he was extremely loyal to Tobias. And it was a serious problem because, thus, let's say you think you arrested Tobias Whale, but in reality, it was Ishmael who was actually shapeshifting, or if someone was to kill someone else in the series, Ishmael can actually shapeshift into that person and no one really know that that person is dead because someone has been standing in that person's spot the whole time. But you guys let me know about the title of the first three episodes so far. It is a three-part, I think, first episode for season two. So actually it might be a two-part, but like I said, there's three episodes that are named the same, basically The Book of Consequence, The Rise of Greenlight Babies, chapter 1, 2, and 3. So you guys let me know what you think is going to happen for the first three episodes, let alone the first episode by itself. But also let me know what you think about season two. And if you're new to the channel, please be sure to like, share, and of course subscribe. And don't forget to leave a comment down below. And make sure you ring that little bell so you can always be notified when we make new videos. And I hope to see you later on. Peace out.